How you doing, guys? Thank you so much for coming back to Cobra TV. We're going to talk a little bit about Waking Titan, but this is going to be talking about what Waking Titan was and what it is. And there's a lot of comments pouring into the channel where people are asking, how do they sign up to get an Atlas Pass? What are Atlas Passes? What is Waking Titan? What happened? And there's a ton of people that just didn't realize Waking Titan was happening, you know, 5-6 months ago. And it's, you know, I scratched my head at that because it was a pretty loud echo throughout the No Man's Sky community. But then you got to stop and think that there's quite a few people who probably don't belong to or get engaged with the No Man's Sky community. They just play the game, and you know, people randomly watch other people's Let's Plays and stuff like that on YouTube. So there's probably a good portion of people out there that didn't even realize Waking Titan actually existed. And, you know, so they don't know what they missed. And a lot of people are thinking that Hello Games is just sending out these things to like YouTubers and community leaders and things like that, these Atlas Passes. And that's not true either. And there's been some people that have been quite upset saying, I've got more hours than anybody. I've got more units than anybody. How come I wasn't asked for my address to be sent an Atlas Pass? And the short and simple answer to that is because it's not that you didn't participate in Waking Titan, so you're not being punished, but participating in Waking Titan is what got everybody's address taken to get an Atlas Pass, because there were emails, you know, you had to sign up with Old Gods and put your email address, you know, register your email address. And then a survey was sent to everybody quite a few surveys, actually, fill out, you know, your address to be sent an Atlas Pass, for a chance to be sent an Atlas Pass. And a lot of people did participate in Waking Titan. At one point in time, I believe there was something that was released that showed like the traffic for individuals visiting. I can't remember where that was or you know, what the numbers were exactly, but it was a lot. It really was. And it kind of played into the lore of Super Lumina as well, about, you know, how many you know, requests were being sent on the webpage or whatever. So what I want to do today is kind of talk about Waking Titan. I'm not going to talk about all of the puzzles. I'd be here all night doing that. But there were several puzzles that, you know, the community helped solve together. Some of them really, really super cool and engaging, while others were, you know, they were kind of weird, you know, like helping a hamster turn left and right by using a vote process on Twitch. So, yeah, there were some pretty cool puzzles. There were some pretty weird puzzles. But it was an amazing thing to see a company such as Hello Games, you know, just be engaged with the community so awesomely as they did. So let's go ahead and talk about Waking Titan and what it was. Now, I'm not reading this off a script. I'm just going off the top of my head. And you got to think, this is half a year ago. So I'm probably going to miss a couple of things, but I'm really just going to talk about some of the main things about Waking Titan to kind of fill people in who weren't paying attention or didn't know or just didn't care to know. And there's a reason why a lot of people didn't care to know about Waking Titan, because back then at the very first, a lot of people didn't even believe that they were even connected to Hello Games. That's because Hello Games never said that they were running Waking Titan. They were not even acknowledging it or anything. They were just keeping very quiet about the whole thing. And so let's go ahead and kind of start a little bit from the beginning, a little bit from the middle, and a little bit from the end. So out of the blue, one day I got a message from somebody who was running a Discord channel. Mr. Unknown, I believe it was. He was one of the Reddit moderators, and he said, "Hey, Hello Games asked us if they could come inside our Discord and poke around." And when they did, he messaged me and said, "Hey, Hello Games asked us for our address." And you know, I'm sitting there like, "Oh, that's strange." Well, about a couple weeks go by, and I got a message from Mr. Unknown, who I believe is now named Mr. Universe. I hope that's right. But anyways, he ended up telling me that he got a package from Hello Games that had a cassette tape in it with some autographed posters, some socks and a pen and things like that, and a ship, the No Man's Sky ship that came with the Explorer's Edition. And he, it was kind of funny because he said, you know, I'm over, I don't know what's on the cassette tape. I'm going to my grandma's house to sit in her Lincoln to play the tape to see what it is. So he did so. It turned out to be on one side was like chiptune versions of the soundtrack of, you know, 65 Days of Static for No Man's Sky, the soundtrack for No Man's Sky. It was like old retro chiptune type music. And on the other side was just a bunch of noise. Well, it turned out that on the other side, the noise, if you looked at it through a spectrograph, it showed a word and it said portal. And so at this point, nobody, hardly anybody on the internet was believing that this was Hello Games. There were people saying it's a troll, or there are people saying that the Reddit moderators are making this up, and things like that. The next thing that happened was there was a separate forum called the ETARC forums, the Edison Township Amateur Radio Club, and they have nothing to do, they had not at the time, okay, they were in disguise as having nothing to do with gaming whatsoever. And they were working on some ARG that Emily had stumbled upon, and they were going to live drops and things like that. And an ARG is an alternate reality game. It's a game that is played out in real life, almost like the movie The Game. It's really interesting when video games do ARGs. It really is. So they came across the string of numbers, and I remember reading back on the thing where they're discussing what the string of numbers could possibly be, and someone mysteriously says, I think these are No Man's Sky coordinates. So what happened was they went over to the Reddit community and said, hey, are these coordinates for your game? And the No Man's Sky Reddit community said that it looks like coordinates for our game. So they plugged it in, they went to the planet, and they found a comm ball, a comm station on the planet. And it read something like loop 16 something. So it gave another code, and it led to a password that was on a site called Waking Titan. Now ETARC and the No Man's Sky Reddit were kind of blending together now to help each other out. The No Man's Sky Reddit page was trying to figure out why this ARG that ETARC was working on was using No Man's Sky coordinates. So at this time, people are like, oh, it's just a fan of the game using the game to further along the ARG for ETARC. And I was convinced that this was Hello Games from the beginning. You know, I'm making videos, and you know, it was kind of scary making these videos because I didn't know for sure if it was Hello Games or not. So throughout this process, I'm gonna skip over a lot of stuff. I'm just going to kind of tell the story so you can get a grasp on what Waking Titan is. So let's see. Waking Titan ended up, I ended up getting a package. The cassette tapes that all the Reddit moderators were given were numbered something out of 16. So 16 was a very prominent number throughout the entire ARG of Waking Titan. And I got the package sent to me, and it was 9 of 16, I believe it was 9 of 16, and it had a cassette tape in it as well, plus an autographed poster, some socks, a pen, a No Man's Sky model ship that I ended up doing a giveaway, and Derek Sword is the one who won that, and I got that sent out to him. So what I did at that moment, since everybody was still uneasy about thinking that it was Hello Games, I used a box to kind of show that the shipping label came from their very brand new studio, and that it said Hello Games on it. And that's what kind of, I believe, people started, you know, letting their guard down a little bit and saying, okay, this has got to be Hello Games. What we learned through Waking Titan was a lot about the lore of Waking Titan. It also had like this undertone of kind of what Hello Games went through. as far as the development and release. And that's speculation. I guess you can connect dots with anything if you're looking for it. But it kind of felt like to me like they were also telling their story about what happened and things like that. But Emily, who was started doing vlog videos about, you know, what was happening with the processes, the process of Waking Titan, the development of Waking Titan with each puzzle and stuff like that. She was doing these weekly vlogs. And so we ended up, she ended up turning out to be an AI. And I believe what we were looking at, if I remember right, is she was loop 15. She was killed off and then loop 16 was created and it was still Emily. So what we're supposed to believe for the ARG is we weren't really looking at a person who was talking to us. We were looking at an AI that was speaking with us. And the Atlas Foundation was a company who made her, and they also made Loop 16. Now, Loop 16, we ended up having to do a Turing test with her, and where we teach her how to think and things like that. And then she came on, and the Atlas Foundation wanted to destroy her, and she came on and said, "Do you guys think I should live?" And so we all voted yes. We could have voted no, because Allison Smith was the company that Hello Games hired to do the ARG, told us at the very end that there was an alternate ending should we have said no. So we learned a lot about the creation of the simulation. We learned a lot about, you know, how the Atlas was created. Now, a lot of people are debating that Emily is not really the Atlas, that the Atlas is actually, that Emily could have been what's called in the game, the Abyss. Abyss is another AI that is mentioned very, very briefly in the game in a log that talks about an AI that is underneath the ocean and people were studying it and it changes reality and does this and that and has a familiar beat, a familiar rhythm like the Atlas does, and it was evil. But I don't think that Emily is Abyss, and the reason why is because the Atlas Foundation created Emily, and the whole Waking Titan was all about the Atlas and the Atlas Foundation. So I really believe that Emily is the Atlas, and because that's what the whole Waking Titan thing was about. But so we all became part of the origin story of No Man's Sky because we were playing the past. We were playing the creation of Emily. We were playing, you know, back when the Atlas Foundation was creating everything that ended up messing everything up. And we allowed her to live. We voted for her to live. We became the origin of that. And through that, we were sent an email to sign up for the Atlas passes. And we did. I think everybody who signed up for the old gods did indeed sign up for those Atlas passes. So that is the reason why everybody's getting Atlas passes. And the Waking Titan thing led to a massive, massive update for the game. This 1.3 literally changed the Steam to Steam reviews to mostly positive, recent mostly positive. It turned it around. I mean, it really did. And so with this update, they're doing Waking Titan again. So I am expecting another substantial update to the game, or if it's not substantial like Atlas Rises, I think it's going to be incremental. Like I think it's going to be a very important update, and I stand strong in my speculation that it's going to be player models, that it could possibly lead to more multiplayer, because they announced during the patch notes of Atlas Rises that the wisps that we all see each other as is the first step in synchronized cooperative gameplay. So since Hello Games kind of opened up their mouth and saying this is the first step, I think that, you know, they know that with every update that they release that people are going to hold their feet to the flames and say, what are you going to do with the cooperative synchronized multiplayer that you talked about? When is that going to, when are you guys going to improve on that? So I really feel like that's one of the main themes that they're going to be focusing on with this next update, which might be 1.5 for some reason. And here we are with Wake and Titan again, getting ready to start back up. The Atlas Passes, I do not believe, have anything to do with the game itself. I think it's a thank you for participating in Waking Titan. Number two, I think it's a collector's item for us as fans. And I think that it's going to be a puzzle piece to move the ARG along. I know when the Atlas Passes were first mentioned, everybody thought that they were beta keys. And Hello Games quickly responded to some of the community leaders in the No Man's Sky Discord, Unimatrix01, to relay the message to the community that these are not beta keys whatsoever. So we can scratch that idea off. I really think that these are just puzzle pieces to move the ARG along. And the whole point is have fun with this ARG. It's an awesome way for Hello Games to interact with this community. And at the end, we are going to get an update. So while we're waiting for this update to come, and we're going to learn more about the lore, and we're going to get clues about what the update could possibly be, and it's just going to be a really, really, really super fun time. I don't think that this ARG is going to go as long as it did the last time. I think this is going to be short-lived, and so there's that at least. Let's see, what else should I cover? Another topic that I would like to speak about is Firefly 753 was mentioned on my subcast by a caller who was trying to connect Firefly 753 to Waking Titan. And to kind of go over that a little bit, the website Myriad looks like, you know, and the password, not password, but the clue left on Myriad, which is a Waking Titan No Man's Sky Hello Games website, is Mirror. There's numbers on the bottom, and it says that, you know, if you turn it into hexadecimal format, that it says Mirror. And then the Atlas Passes that are coming out literally say, and a string of numbers that says Phoenix. If you turn it into hexadecimal format. A lot of people connected to the Phoenix Lights, which is a mirror-filled room in the dark with strands of lights that are called fireflies. And these fireflies represent 10,000 fireflies, there's 10,000 Atlas Passes, and if you're standing in the middle of the room, it says it looks like you're in an open galaxy. So this is a real piece of art from a real artist, in Japan, and it has a lot of in common with what's going on right now. Now, maybe the ARG is using, because they've used things like that before, you know, maybe they're using this piece of art for clues. But a lot of people think that, and I think as well, that the Myriad site is a stock image of lights. I don't think it's the Phoenix lights, but there is too much. There's a lot in common with the Phoenix Art Museum, the 10,000 fireflies. Now, there was Firefly 753. There's also a number on the Atlas Passes that say 15. So. I guess somebody went to a planet and something was discovered to a planet and something was discovered by Firefly 753. I can't remember how people associated that planet, why they went to that specific planet was with, you know, this Firefly 753 had discovered. But it turns out Firefly 753 is actually Mad Hatter, who was on what used to be the old ETARC forums. The new name of the website is now escaping me. But Firefly 753, Mad Hatter, issued a statement that he's not a part of the ARG, and I 100% believe him. And, you know, I mean, when we're talking about this Waking Titan thing, if you were one of the ones that went through it, we went through absolute hell connecting dots to things that didn't need to be connected. And I think, you know, it's a possibility that, you know, the ARG, you know, Allison Smith could be using the Phoenix lights the Firefly lights to, you know, give us a hint or a clue to something. It's a possibility. I don't know if that's, I'm not certain on that. But what I am certain on is Firefly 753, which if you add the 753 together, it, you know, adds up to 15. So I am certain that he is not part of the ARG. So if, you know, and I reached out to him and I apologize for that being said on the show. And he was really great about it, really cool about it. And so let's take a little bit of heat off of Firefly 753. I don't believe he's part of this. He is one of the leaders over there on the website, on the old ETARC website, Atlas 7075, something like that. I'll link it in the video here. But again, I stand strong. I don't believe Firefly 753, aka Mad Hatter, has anything to do with the ARG whatsoever. And if he does, it's really not cool to point out the actors, because that kind of lifts up the curtain a little bit. But I don't think that's what the case is here. I don't think that he's pretending, or I don't think he's an actor or an NPC in the ARG or anything like that. So I guess we can kind of just pitch that. You're going to find a lot of commonalities when we're looking and searching and trying to connect dots. We can connect dots to a lot of things, but I think this one is a dead end. So the most important thing with the ARG, though, is Allison Smith, who's hired by Hello Games to run it, is going to guide us along. They will guide us along, and there won't be anything that could possibly be missed. They will produce this and direct this in a manner to where we'll know when we're supposed to know. And that's what's happening right now. We're waiting for all the Atlas passes to come in. Seems like only people from Canada are getting them. And after, I think, a lot more people get them, we're going to it's going to move along. I think a website is going to change or update. Possibly Myriad is going to change or update. Waking Titan will change or update. And there's a lot of things that you could type inside WakingTitan.com. You could type in ship and see a ship. That was the exotic ships that we were hinted a long time ago. We didn't know what they were. And now we know. And you could type in who is Atlas, who is, you know, Nada, who is Polo, tons and tons of things to type inside Waking Titan. And a lot of people who weren't paying attention are finding out those things now, which shows me that they're really intelligent. You know, they don't know these things. And a lot of people are messaging me saying, hey, Cobra, if you type in who is Atlas or who is this, you get this. And that shows a lot of intelligence. They weren't around for the first battle of Waking Titan, so therefore they're figuring this stuff out on their own without any community help. So it's pretty cool, really is. So if you see anybody in the comment section who could use a little bit of help, anybody that, you know, if I didn't explain Waking Titan very well, then, you know, help them out. We're all a big community. We're here to help each other, and I think it's amazing. So Waking Titan is an ARG, which is an alternate reality game played in real life about the subject matter, which is No Man's Sky, and led us to a bunch of puzzles, taught us a bunch of lore, and had us all waiting on pins and needles for an update, which happened to be a very massive update, the Atlas Rises update. So I'm expecting the same this time around. Learn more about the lore, have some interesting puzzles to go through, and meet new friends, make, you know, build new friendships, build bigger communities, you know, help each other out, and just sit back and enjoy the ride. And guess what? There's going to be gold at the end of the rainbow. There's going to be a nice big, well, there's going to be a nice update. I don't know if it's going to be big like last time or not, but there's going to be a nice update. I mean, we could all use one right about now, I think. So that's it in a nutshell. If you have any questions, just comment down below. I'll do my best to jump down there and help, you know, help you guys out. And if anybody else sees it and that I don't see a comment, please help them out. And enjoy making friendships and building bigger communities, whether what communities you have on Facebook or people building websites and forums and things like that. It's amazing, really amazing. So we're going to be doing our subcast next Tuesday, or if something big happens, we'll be doing an emergency subcast. A subcast is a podcast with my subscribers. You can call in and talk to me, bring up any start any kind of conversation you want, any topic, different game, whatever. Talk about your YouTube channel, plug your YouTube channel, plug your social media, whatever you want to do. The subcaster, it's your show, so you can come on and say whatever you want. So I'm going to go ahead and get off of here. That's all I have for you today. I just want to kind of try and help people out a little bit about what Waking Titan was, and, you know, expect the same thing this time around. We do have videos in chronological order of Waking Titan, so you might want to go down and kind of get caught up on some of the shorter videos that I have. You can kind of skip the subcast Waking Titan videos, because those are just long discussions with people about what's going on. But the shorter ones, they are discussing what was happening at that time. So each development, each new thing had a video we talked about. So they're all down there, in the previous, uploaded videos or whatever. So you can kind of get a, you know, idea of what we went through and what you could possibly be going through this time. So that's all I've got for you today, guys. That's all I got for you today, guys. As always, I love it, and I'll see you all in the next video. Until next time.